Guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are doing a mini review slash first impressions on the Fitbit Lux. Okay, if you've been around on my channel, you know I have had every freaking Fitbit under the sun. Now, I've recently been comparing data between the Whoop, and initially I was doing the Garmin. If you didn't see that video, go check it out. And I also wanted to do a comparison between the sleep data from my Whoop and the 8 Sleep cover pod mattress situation. That will be coming probably at the end of August, like mid to end of August. I just wanted as much data as possible and to get like a full couple of months worth out of the 8 Sleep. But I will say, I mentioned it in my favorites video, and I do still absolutely love it. Highly recommend. But in terms of like data comparison, I just needed a little bit more time. So instead, I'm going to be discussing the Fitbit Lux today. This is the first fashion style fitness watch that I've owned, and there's definitely some pros and cons to it. But if you didn't see my previous video, I returned the Garmin because unfortunately, because I have a full sleeve on my right arm and I do have ink on my, I have a full sleeve on my left arm and I have ink on my right arm, the Garmin did not track my heart rate consistently on either arm. Unfortunately, before we even get into the review, I'm just gonna say it right off the bat. If you are a fully tattooed, sleeved person, the Fitbit Lux is most likely not going to be the Fitbit for you. So I'm gonna just put it right out there, right off the bat. But let's get on into the review. The biggest advertisement portion that Fitbit has given for this Fitbit Lux is just that it's fashionable. So of course, aesthetically, I'm gonna take it off so you can see it up close. I will say this is probably one of my favorite Fitbits just because of the very sleek design. One of the biggest complaints that I know a lot of people have, myself included, about the other Fitbits, like the Sense and the Versa and all that, is the side buttons. So this Fitbit Lux does not have the same side buttons that are on the Sense and the Versa. So in terms of working out, if you're doing anything like overhead, you're doing push-ups, you're bending your wrist back and forth, it is not going to affect your workout at all, and I can confirm that. So in terms of like flexibility and comfort, I absolutely love this. And I do love that, and maybe this is just something I've never noticed before because I mentioned it in my Garmin video, but I love how it has that little stopper underneath the like clip part, I guess, of the watch. When you put it on, the end of it doesn't flop around, which I really like. It's very nice and sleek. It is so light and comfortable. And just like, honestly, I feel like aesthetically, this is so nice. Like, it's not bulky. If you're somebody who doesn't like bulky fitness watches, this would be fantastic for you. But again, keep in mind, it does not read through ink. Now, as a side note, some people have said that it read through their ink. When I did a little research, I found out that it can also depend on the type of ink, how deep your tattoos are in the layers of your skin. There's a lot of components that will make it less effective if you are somebody who is fully sleeved or has dark tattoos or darker skin in general. And from my understanding, because the underside heart rate sensor is not as wide as like the Versa or the Sense, because they're obviously a square and they have double the sensors, that's why this one is struggling so much. So it's a catch-22 because it's so aesthetic, it's so thin, comfortable, easy, but unfortunately the heart rate sensor is going to be lacking a little bit. The cool thing is, in terms of aesthetics, you can change this band out to make it look more jewelry-like. So if you're somebody who works in an office, they have like these gold bands, these jewelry looking things and all that kind of stuff. So if that's something that you're interested in, then I think this one is definitely a more fashion style watch, if you will. And if you don't necessarily care about, you know, like swiping through certain things, or you don't really want to be touching your watch screen a ton, I think this is great. With that being said, you can receive calls on this. I can see most of the text message, depending on how long it is, on this little screen. Let me take it off again so I can show you up close and personal so you can see how the screen looks. Obviously, the face setting on this guy is much smaller than the Versas or the Senses. So you can swipe left to right on this guy to set alarms, kind of the same thing as the Versa and the Sense, but obviously you just have less space to work with here on the watch. So you can go down, you can go up, right and left. If you've owned a Fitbit before, it's basically just like a condensed Fitbit. So it just doesn't have as much room. And then let me show you the back so you can see the heart rate sensor. See how it's just obviously a lot thinner. You're just gonna get less accurate readings if you do have those things that interfere with the heart rates. I like that they went with the color display on this. I feel like if they didn't, it would almost kind of be like a kid's watch. You know, like the Fitbit kids ones, they're just kind of like, they seem like early 2000s. So I did like that they went with a color screen. It's very bright. It looks nice, like your regular Fitbits. I had the Sense before this and I did send it back because after the update, which again, as I was doing my research, I found out a lot of people had this issue. When I did the last update, that was when the watch just completely crashed and burned. And so they had me send it back and they're supposed to be sending me a new one. I haven't gotten an update on that though, so I'll let you know. But it is the same type of LED screen that is automatically adjusting, you know, like if you have it on as like the turn your watch over, it lights up. You can change the brightness, you can change the watch faces and all that good stuff. Same as regular Fitbits. There's not a ton different between this Lux. Like this Lux is not an additional cool feature that Fitbit decided to offer that's like new and fancy. If anything, it's like a small condensed version of your traditional Fitbits for people who don't really care so much about the watch face, the big and bulky, the tech stuff, and the fitness stuff. Although, you do have all-day activity tracking, you have pace and time and distance, you have your menstrual health tracking, you have your sleep modes, it's swim-proof and waterproof, which is awesome. I reviewed a thinner Fitbit like this back in the day that didn't have the smart features on it, if you will, and I did not like it. So I think this is cool. It's kind of like an in-between smartwatch-y meets fitness fashion, but not really if fitness is your entire life, you know? Like, so for me right now in this current situation that I have, the Whoop is giving me the data for metrics in terms of like performance, recovery, sleep. The Whoop does not have any issue reading through my ink on either arm, which is great. But when it comes to the steps, of course, Whoop does not have steps, Whoop does not have a screen. So we're back to two fitness watches again. But I feel like this is perfect for that. Like, it allows me to wear double watches without being like super obnoxious, but it still tracks my steps and my activity. Like when I did go into the app, I could still see my Peloton workouts were synced. Everything was pretty normal. So overall, I would say that I think this is a great watch for somebody who doesn't really care too much about performance metrics, but still loves the Fitbit app interface. Like maybe you just don't want to switch away from Fitbit and go to Garmin, but you just want a more simplistic version or honestly just a more like fashionable Fitbit. I think this is definitely the nicest looking one of them all. You just kind of want to have like something there to look at, and you can also get your calls on it, your texts, and do other things with it if you wanted to. And of course, it has that 5-day battery life, which is awesome. With that being said, of course, I am unable to get the sleep data and the other data that I would love to typically have with Fitbit. And I didn't have that issue with my Sense. My Sense tracked my sleep just fine. I've worn it on both wrists before. I've never had an issue with it reading through ink. So I'm really hoping that when they send me my new one, I don't have this issue because I don't know what the heck watch I'm gonna wear. I like a screen. Like I like to be able to see what time it is. I like to be buzzed when I'm getting a phone call. I like to see my steps. I don't know. I'm just somebody. I said this in my damn Garmin video. Somebody needs to make this look less hideous. Like make this look like this, but then have the data from here and here. We need to merge these. That's what we need to do. I don't have any cool data to show you, unfortunately, because it is not accurately reading my heart rate. But if you don't have tattoos, you won't have that problem. So that is my little mini review on the Fitbit Lux. I do like it. I just wish it read my heart rate. Let me know what you think. Let me know what other Fitbit trackers or fitness trackers in general you think I should try. And of course, as always, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and click that subscribe button. Hit the notification so you're always notified when I make new videos, which is Monday and Thursday. And that is all I have for you in today's video. I will talk to you in my next one.